From its founding, the University of North Dakota has been driven by innovation and growth, an interdisciplinary system with a rich history of collaboration. Early on, Babcock Hall housed the engineering and chemistry departments. Through the years, from old science to Whitmer, Upson to O'Kelly, UND has provided an educational experience second to none. And now, with a reputation as leaders in STEM education and research, UND is poised to shape the future of engineering and science in North Dakota and beyond.
The STEM Complex is a new facility that'll go on the site of Hislop, and it'll house programs in the College of Engineering and Mines as well as in the College of Arts and Sciences.
The approach we're taking, I think, is somewhat unique, that it's we're trying to build a collaborative, innovative space that'll simulate the real world that students get into, where there's a lot of diversity in background, diversity in knowledge. I think the collaboration between engineering and scientists in the same building, I think there's going to be a lot of synergy that comes out of that, a lot of great ideas that come out of that, just by being in close proximity and working together.
Collaboration is just such an important part of science and engineering today. So we have these traditional academic disciplines, and we're working hard to break down the barriers between them, because where real innovation happens is where you get folks from different backgrounds coming together and coming up with entirely new things. It really will be transformational on this campus. So if you picture the east end of campus where Hislop is now and all of the construction that's gone on the other side of Columbia and with the new union, this entire end of campus is going to be transformed. And what I'm excited about is it will put science and engineering in a very visible place and highlight the importance of science and engineering to the university and to the region and its economy.
Yeah, we're very fortunate and thankful for the support of the state of North Dakota in getting this project off the ground. And we're actively involved in fundraising the remaining portion of the building. And so, you know, support from donors, support from alumni, support from industry in the area as we develop the science and engineering workforce, something that's needed.
What really drives me is the need to produce more scientists and engineers for North Dakota. I grew up in the state, and our role as in workforce development in North Dakota is really important to me. This facility is critical for us to attract those students who will then become scientists and engineers serving the North Dakota economy. So that's what I'm most excited about, is just the ability to build this critical piece of infrastructure for the state of North Dakota.